Hello children, so welcome to my video session. Today we shall be taking up a topic, diversity in living organisms. Under this topic, we shall try to cover up today three subtopics, that is Kingdom Monera, Protista and Fungi. Kingdom Monera, Protista and Fungi, these three subtopics I shall be taking up. So first of all, Monera. The most fundamental characteristic of the members of Kingdom Monera is, number one, they are all prokaryote, and number two, they are all unicellular. So they are unicellular prokaryote. Number three, they can be autotrophic or heterotrophic. So these are the three most fundamental characteristic property of the members belonging to Kingdom Monera. So individually we shall discuss what are the members belongs to this Monera. But remember, they are all prokaryotic in nature. That means they do not have membrane bound nucleus. They do not have membrane bound organelle. Examples of this: bacteria, all the bacteria belongs to Kingdom Monera. Blue-green algae, blue-green algae. This blue-green algae is nothing but a kind of bacteria called cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria. How they look like? Let me give one example of a bacteria. They are having nucleoid. That is not true nucleus, not membrane bound, and other membrane bound organelle are absent. All the different types of bacteria, if you categorize the bacteria, they are of different type, like comma shape, like rod shape. So Bacillus, Coccus, Vipro, and Spirillum. These are the different types of bacteria based on their shape, and all belongs to prokaryote. That means they are under phylum Monera. Is it clear to you? Now, coming to the point of blue-green algae, otherwise we called them as cyanobacteria. Let me make a blue-green algae colony. These are the individual cell. These are the individual cell. These are each individual cell. They have chlorophyll pigment, hence they are photosynthetic in nature. But only chlorophyll A pigment present in this group of cyanobacteria, but they do not have membrane bound organelle, no membrane bound organelle, hence they are prokaryote, belongs to Monera. So this is the simplified diagram of cyanobacteria, blue-green algae, and somewhere these types of heterocyst present, these types of heterocyst present. This is heterocyst. And a mucilage coat covering the entire colony. Mucilage coat. This is the mucilage coat. So this is the mucilage coat. So we have given you the example of the members belongs to Kingdom Monera, the most fundamental characteristics, that is they all are prokaryote, do not have any membrane bound organelle, and they are unicellular. These are one such bacteria forming a colony, and they can be autotrophic or heterotrophic. Say for example, the bacteria, other bacteria I have drawn earlier, that is heterotrophic, whereas this one, cyanobacteria or blue-green algae, this is autotrophic. So this is about the Monera. Next, let us come to next kingdom, that is Protista. So coming to the kingdom Protista. The most fundamental character of this kingdom Protista, all the member belongs to this kingdom. They are all eukaryote. Eukaryote means they have true nucleus, membrane-bound nucleus. They have membrane-bound other organelle like mitochondria, like Golgi body, like endoplasmic reticulum, etc. And they all are unicellular again, but eukaryotic. They can have a locomotory organ, cilia, fine hair-like structure covering the body, or can have flagella. The members of this kingdom can be autotrophic or can be heterotrophic. Say for example, Euglena. Euglena. Let me draw the diagram of Euglena, so that the things will be very clear to you. This is Euglena having a flagella, having true nucleus with nucleolus, nuclear membrane, have endoplasmic reticulum, this is endoplasmic reticulum, have Golgi body, this is the Golgi body, Golgi body. Having mitochondria, this substructure and mitochondria and they have plastid. This is plastid. Because of the presence of chloroplast, Euglena, although being a member of animal under protista, but they can prepare their own food by photosynthesis. Hence, they are autotrophic by nature. Eukaryote, unicellular autotroph, belongs to protista. Heterotrophs belongs to protista. Again, all are unicellular. All the members are unicellular. Say, for example, amoeba or paramecium. Let me draw a diagram of paramecium. This is paramecium. Paramecium having cilia, fine hair-like structures covering its entire body, which acts as a locomotory organ. This is paramecium. These are the cilia having two nucleus. One is kidney shape, bigger macronucleus, and the other one is a round shape, spherical, small nucleus called micronucleus. So these are the nucleus, have water vacuole looking like this. Water vacuole having food vacuole. This is water vacuole. Water vacuole. And this is food vacuole. Food vacuole. And other membrane bound all organelles except plastid present in this unicellular member of protista called paramecium. So they are by nature heterotrophic. This is the gullet, that means entry of food particle through this aperture. Now another member of same protista that is very common, irregular shape, called amoeba. Amoeba having a nucleus, single nucleus. It is having food vacuole. Other nuclear membrane and all the components present within the nucleus, hence it's a true nucleus, and other membrane bound organelle also present. During the process of taking of food, this amoeba, suppose this is a food particle located by amoeba, so they will form a false extension from its body. This is the false extension. This false extension we call pseudopodia. Pseudopodia. So let me write here pseudopodia. Pseudopodia. This extension further enlarge to form a food vacuole, and in that way the food is entering to the amoeba cell itself. So these are the examples of the members belongs to protista. All are unicellular and all are eukaryotic. They can be autotrophic like euglena or heterotrophic like paramecium or amoeba. Now we are coming to the next kingdom of five kingdom system of R.H. Whitaker. The third kingdom we shall be taking up, that is fungi or fungus. They can be unicellular or multicellular, but mostly are multicellular. Unicellular fungi like yeast, and multicellular fungi mold. All the members are eukaryotic in nature, and all are heterotroph. That means no member belongs to fungus or fungi can prepare their food. No, they cannot prepare their food. So they are heterotroph. They obtain their food from dead and decomposed organic matter. That type of heterotrophic nutrition we call saprotrophic nutrition or saprophytic. Nutrition. And hence they are called saprotroph. Say for example, let me give you the example, very very common example under this fungus. Say penicillium. Let me draw the diagram. Penicillium. This is the structure of penicillium conidia. This is the penicillium. Structure of penicillium. This is exogenously developed spores from which it will give rise to its new generation.
This is penicillium. 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 We shall draw another member, Aspergillus. Aspergillus. Aspergillus these all are multicellular, that is mold, unicellular fungi, yeast, whereas this diagrams we are showing that is all are multicellular. Yeast also I'll draw. Aspergillus, multicellular fungi, Aspergillus. And another very common, all of you have seen it, especially during moist weather, growing on dead wood or cow dung. Is Agaricus. Is that clear? And unicellular fungi, fungus, that is yeast. Yeast, unicellular fungus. Why? This is yeast. Unicellular fungus, during asexual mode of reproduction, they produce small outgrowth called bud. So, the members belong to fungus or fungi, they all are heterotrophic, they are called saprophyte because they obtain their food from dead and decomposed organic matter. They are all eukaryotes and they are either unicellular like yeast or multicellular called mold. Members belonging to multicellular fungi, Penicillium, Aspergillus, Agaricus. So that's all for today. See you in my next session. Till then, thank you.